Stated that, quote unquote, process, he says, of breaking up. The police had questioned him about an earlier account that he had given during the initial investigation, in which he said that during a fight a couple months ago, a couple months prior to the disappearance, Trudie had come to blows. So things obviously got violent. So he was questioned about their relationship and just how, you know, violent it was. And he said that he didn't recall ever saying that. So Steve, after he lost sight of the van, he actually went to Trudie's house. And Trudie's mom was there, of course, waiting for Trudie to arrive. And Steve took matters into his own hand, and he actually borrowed a bicycle from whom we don't know, but he borrowed a bicycle, and he decided to ride around the beaches for a while. But after some time, he just figured, you know, she probably just stayed over a friend's house, and, you know, everything's fine. So he decided to go home. He did then join the extensive police search along with Trudie's friends, and Steve's movements during the hours of Trudie's whereabouts at the club are unknown, so that's a little sus. Allegedly, he was on the upper floor of the club drinking, and he claimed he wasn't heavily intoxicated. He and Trudie did sometimes smoke marijuana, and I'll get to why that's even, like, related or should be, like, a fact in this case, but there is a theory related to this, so it all makes sense in the end. But yeah, they were known to smoke marijuana together. So he was looked into, and of course he was dismissed at the time as not being involved in this game. So then we have the Roselands lads. Now these guys are definitely sus. So the Roselands lads were known to have prowled the peninsula at the time of the abduction. Two members had cars fitting the description of the vehicles involved: Gary and Carr, Gary Ireland, and Keith Herney bragged numerous times that they had raped and murdered Trudie Adams. Allegedly, Keith Herney told his girlfriend, who testified at the 2011 inquest, that Adams was abducted and raped inside a Gumby van. And remember that green Gumby van? And she later then received a fatal head injury when she either jumped or was pushed from the vehicle. So, police determined that these men were simply boasting, and there was no solid evidence to tie them to the crime. Then we have Neville Tween. So, Neville Tween was the prime suspect in the 2011 inquest. In 1978, Tween, who is now known as John Anderson, quite a name switch there, but he had a long criminal record going back to when he was 10 years old. Yeah, that young. In 1975, he was convicted of abducting a man after a marijuana deal gone wrong and forcing him to fellate, which is a sexual act, his abductors, and then dig his own grave in bushland off This was going to be Trudie's first time in Bali, if I'm not mistaken. So, yeah, Norris had visited Bali a few times, and Trudie had also mentioned to her mother that there was several people, we don't know who, that were harassing her. And lastly, there was a woman by the name of Caroline Drake who knew Trudie, and she actually came forward and claimed her and her boyfriend were actually the ones who picked up Trudie that night at the club and drove her home. So, the weird part about this is that she apparently confessed this to